Earlier this year, the sheriff's office, in conjunction with the city of Holt, approached the county commission about providing law enforcement services to the city of Holt. And we've done that and been doing that for a while. It's a successful program. We recently were approached by the city of Mosby, Missouri, requesting to do the same thing. They have since disbanded their law enforcement agency, as I understand it, and are requesting the same type of agreement that was executed with the city of Holt. They also will be used for the city of Mosby. And it's the exact same contract language and everything as was used by the city of Holt and approved by the county councilor's office also.
Slight caveat on this one is they did cancel their law enforcement insurance when they disbanded their law enforcement police force. So I would request this actually, if you're inclined to put it on consent, I'd actually still request we put on regular so that we can have an opportunity to state that policy.
I was actually, because I would like to give a little more information, I was thinking putting it on regular agenda might be our best option at that point. One of the questions that I would have is, this is the second municipality course. Do we anticipate any more municipalities going down the road? And what would be the, if you have a handle on what might possibly be the fiscal amount of this?
I'm going to defer to Captain Hunter from the operations division for that question.
Good morning. It's very possible to have more municipalities holding and relying on us for those services. I've heard different things, but nothing.
What is it that's kind of firing this trend, so to speak?
Money budget.
Make sure I can address your question about the impact cities or county, where these cities doing it. I'd like to say that there is not that this is essentially this is the city. The cities in these cases are paying separately to our deputies, so we're not paying, it's not on our payroll, it's on theirs. Arguably the two things that could have some potential impact if there's a liability problem, we're not going to be completely absolved. We believe we would be, we try to set up in the best way we can, but if there's a liability problem, we may get pulled into it, we'll try to pull ourselves out. And then the second thing is, I think they are using our vehicles, and so there's always some wear and tear. I think there's some payment for that, but there's still wear and tear on the vehicles.
For mileage.
Yeah, so they're paying it, but many people would look at this as, it's really zero impact to the county. That's a fair way to look at it, but there are potential issues out there, I guess.
So, if I understand correctly, the cities are, to a large degree, keeping the county whole as far as the finances of the other. Maybe a few things here and there, but it's not really too high a dollar figure. And, when you start talking about, larger or like a federal, it's obviously. That was one of my concerns as I realized, as we go through the budget process, that the manpower is the issue, and I had some concerns about putting more stress on that force. So that was kind of what was behind that. I mean, we're talking about Mosby, that size, it's somewhat doable, but when we get into like the village of Clicomo, that's a larger issue. Saying there are other municipalities that make all that categories on. That's kind of the ongoing concern. That's why they try not to put it on consent and on regular, because I don't want to send a message that this is something we don't attach any importance to, but we do want to make sure that while we are being relatively held harmless financially, there still is the stress on the force that is bound to do a number of other duties that are extremely important. Yes.
With regard to the hours of coverage, is there a would there be set control times, or would there be somebody, a group of people who would be here at some point throughout, you know, 24/7?
Well, they want to drive here. I'm both scared at that point. And definitely doing that, you know, if you're off work, we prefer them to be off work. If they are, we'll do that. We want to let our chefs on there who live like that, that put them off for you.
Right. So it wouldn't count as our overtime. This would be something that they would.
Right.
Totally separate. And then, I just want our staff to work with the sheriff's department to make sure that we've got our costs more covered. And another question I have for you, if an officer from our sheriff's department writes some sort of violation, whether it be speeding or drunk driving, something like that, is that something that is filed and then goes through state court for prosecution?
Yes, they're coordinating, basically, stripped back of their provision, so.
And then that's not terrible. It will be probably done here in Provision 7, but I think the way it works is, in that situation, Provision 7 is sitting as a municipal court. They're not sitting as a state court.
But here's the question I've got, and maybe it's a question that we're going to have to get answered later. Because the Mosmart board undercut us and took away $100,000+ that we will no longer have supplemented for our deputy sheriff's salaries. All of that is paid by court costs for cases that go through state court. So as we're picking up Holt and we're picking up Mosby and we stand the potential of picking up others, what some of the larger counties that are donor counties to the Mosmart Board who have suffered a great financial loss, and goes to Commissioner Nolte's point of how we can help pay for and so that our force isn't stretched to the max. If we can find a way to keep some of those monies at home, other counties have made the decision to have county municipal courts. And that doesn't mean that they're prosecuting, you know, the high class felony cases or anything like that. That stays in state court. But it seems to me that as we're picking up more and more of these that are going to be the first time DWIs, the speeding tickets, the, you know, maybe disorderly conduct, something like that, that could go through our municipal court system, we need to really check this out. I've had some preliminary discussions with other first class counties, non-chartered, that have set county municipal courts up, and they more than pay for themselves in the first year. So,
that's one thing we still have to come up with, too. We're still researching that. We have to write up your attention, but we're still having that conversation to have that actually work.
I would really like to get at some point, and it may be premature to set it, to request that it be set as an official discussion item, but I'd really like to get a working group together to pull those numbers together and find out, because we've already done a little bit of research through the BRIA, through the Office of State Courts Administrator. And it looks like to me that if, rather than us relying on legislation in the future that's going to bring those fees back home, and we're losing, $180,000?
We were at $180,000 2 years ago this past fiscal year, not our year, but the fiscal year of the state was, I believe, $164,000. And the year that we have just commenced, we were down to $23,000. So those numbers are dramatic decreases, especially given the amount of money that we contribute to that fund, which is it approaching $500,000? So out of $500,000 that we put into the program, we get $23,000 back.
That sounds like a bad deal.
It does. I was going to mention this during my comments, but as long as we're on the subject, I brought this up to a number of other people, the subject, and it is now on the agenda of legislation that they might push at Mid-America Regional Council. So they've heard what we've had to say. They also have, I think, heard similar stories from Platte County and other counties of that size, and I think that we have a chance to at least go back and try to get fair representation from first-class counties. as we get closer, obviously, legislation cannot be approved by until December 1, but that's certainly something that we want to pursue. It would be, I think it would not be a good thing for this county to say, yeah, well, we lost it, so what the heck. We need to be vigorous in putting forward the agenda that is going to serve our citizens the best that we can.
Well, if you guys don't mind, we can send you the research that we've done so far, basically on the same ones.
I'm happy to work along those lines. What I would suggest is, how would you prefer? I mean, just get in touch with, get the information to the county administrator, and then we can figure out from our side who kind of needs to be on the team. Look at that, and maybe try to pull that together and look at the numbers, because even if we are successful in getting the legislation passed, we're still going to lose another whole year towards, and it's not probably going to get any better. So,
That legislation would only change the future makeup of the board. It would do nothing to him, so he would have to wait until there was a appointment made by the governor. So there could be a heck of a timeline on that. And even at that point, the first of us counties would have one out of five votes, possibly two, likely just one, and would still be certainly in the minority. On the issue that you raised of a county court, it sounds like we've all been working on parallel lines on this, because I've been pursuing with different people similar subjects. So, Commissioner Ridgeway, I think that it is an absolutely great item for discussion. My suggestion would be that we continue to do our research, and possibly after the budget is put to bed, so to speak, mm-hmm. then we can sit down and start attacking this issue possibly in January.
It needs to probably even be raised during our budget discussions, because if we decide to implement that, the startup costs do have a budgetary impact, but the long-term impact is a positive fiscal impact. And it does require, we'll save it for discussion for another day, but if we can get an informal group together between our staffs, then as the elected officials, sheriff and so on, has an opportunity to sit in on it, the commissioner's have an opportunity to sit in on it, we'll notice whatever needs are necessary. But I think we really have to pile on this thing, because that's the liability, the costs, and the technology. I can see this is an area where that we're going to be asked to partner with more than one of our staff.
I think you're probably right. You know, I don't mind starting sooner than later on that. So, yeah, whenever we have enough facts to be able to have a discussion in commission meeting, I think we should go forward, because it will take some time to set it up. And you raise a good point that we need to be at least some accounting for what the expense would be in our budget. Despite the fact that we're probably having a net positive note, it still is going to be an expenditure.
And I'm happy to receive copies of whatever you send. I just thought if you send to the county administrator, something probably at a time working on something probably working with everyone. That's fantastic.
So we will put that 2015-357 regular.
If I may put it on next this coming Monday, the 9th, or put it on immediate action on the 23rd, or the regular.
Hopefully, again, may not be available. Is there any particular, would it do any harm for us to put some immediate action on the 23rd as far as the timeline goes? Let's go ahead and work on